I find a poem often grows out of a phrase that's popped up from some hidden corner of my subconscious. This phrase is quite likely to end up as part of the first line, or it might turn out to belong somewhere else in the poem, or even not to belong there at all. It might disappear in the revision. But I've only once had the experience of getting the title first and being left to work out from that what the poem was going to be. The title that came to me was The Ex-Queen Among the Astronomers. What did it mean? Who was this ex-queen? Someone from the Middle East, I thought. Perhaps someone whose photograph I'd seen in the newspapers in the 1950s, divorced by a king because she couldn't produce an heir. As for the astronomers, I spent a happy morning with the Encyclopaedia Britannica. After that, the poem took on its own momentum. What it turned out to be saying, when I looked at it afterwards, was that women who have been trained to exist merely for the satisfaction of men are unlikely to be much good for anything else. But that's being wise after the event. Here's the poem, The Ex-Queen Among the Astronomers. They serve revolving saucer eyes, dishes of stars. They wait upon huge lenses hung aloft to frame the slow procession of the skies. They calculate, adjust, record, watch transits, measure distances. They carry pocket telescopes to spy through when they walk abroad. Spectra possess their eyes. They face upwards, alert for meteorites, cherishing little glassy worlds, receptacles for outer space. But she, exile, expelled, ex-queen, swishes among the men of science, waiting for cloudy skies, for nights when constellations can't be seen. She wears the rings he let her keep. She walks as she was taught to walk for his approval years ago. His bitter features taunt her sleep. And so when these have laid aside their telescopes, when lids are closed between machines and sky, she seeks terrestrial bodies to bestride. She plucks this one or that among the astronomers and is become his canopy, his occultation. She sucks at earlobe, penis, tongue, mouthing the tubes of flesh. Her hair crackles, her eyes are comet sparks. She brings the distant briefly close above his dreamy, abstract stare.